Hello friends, welcome to Manu Law Classes. I am Gautam Dixit. Today in this video, we are going to discuss important questions of the month of September 2021. So let's start. We at Manu Law Classes, we have already launched 1 year and 2 year course. You can enroll today by calling us at 9971444, or you can visit us at our website www.lawentranceindia.com. Then we have a unique concept of 15-day free trials, where you will have access to live classes with one-to-one interaction, recorded conceptual lectures on various topics, as well as access to topic and sectional test and your performance analysis in both these tests. You can go into the description link. You will find the link. Just click on that link and you fill the form and you are set to access the 15-day free trials. Now let's come to the question. The first question is, the GDP of India grew by dash in the first quarter of the financial year 2021-22 as per the data released by the National Statistics Office in September 2021. National Statistics Office ने जो data भी recently release किया है उसके हिसाब से जो GDP growth था पूरे साल का नहीं सिर्फ first quarter of the financial year 2021-22 was A 24.8%, B 20.1%, C 25%, D 18.8%, E none of the above. So let's go to the right answer. The right answer is B 20.1%. So according to the NSO data released in September 2021, the India's gross domestic product grew by 20.1% in the first quarter of 2021-22. And if we see and compare it with the first quarter of 2020-21, when there was the first wave of COVID-19 pandemic going on, there was a contraction, means minus 24.4%. Okay, but even the GDP growth is 20.1%, as you can see, the economic activity is well below the pre-pandemic level. Means lockdown kab laga? March 2020. Uske pehle jo GDP growth tha, okay, jo economic activity thi, अभी तक हम वहाँ पे नहीं पहुँचे हैं. इसका मतलब हमारी रिकवरी अभी कंप्लीट नहीं हुई है. देयर आर सर्टन सेक्टर्स विच हैव रीच द प्री पेंडेमिक लेवल. दिस सेक्टर्स आर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, गैस, वाटर सप्लाई, एग्रीकल्चर, फॉरेस्ट्री एंड फिशिंग. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द चाइना म्यांमार न्यू पैसेज लिंक्स विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग. A. Yangon in Myanmar with Chengdu in China. B. Yangon in Myanmar with Beijing in China. Then Kyokfu in Myanmar with Shanghai in China. Then Kyokfu in Myanmar with Chengdu in China, or none of the above. So the correct answer is A. Yangon in Myanmar to Chengdu in China. So it is called, the formal name is the China Myanmar Transport Corridor. The China Myanmar Transport Corridor. It is a sea road rail. Tino. का लिंक है यहाँ पे, और ये जो पूरा लिंक है इट इज गोइंग टू कनेक्ट सिंगापुर विद म्यांमार एंड देन म्यांमार टू चाइना. सो गुड्स फ्रॉम सिंगापुर कैन रीच यांगोन पोर्ट थ्रू अंडमान सी एंड देन दे कैन बी ट्रांसपोर्टेड बाय रोड टू लिंकैंग ऑन द चाइनीज साइड ऑफ द म्यांमार चाइना बॉर्डर. द नेक्स्ट इज द डेल्टा वेरियंट ऑफ सार्स कोविड 2 इज also known as so let's move to the correct answer. The correct answer is B.1.617.2. so there is a variant which is called as B.1.617. it has three lineages which are B.1.617.1, 617.1, then B.1.617.2, then B.1.617.3, sorry. So इसमें से जो डॉट टू है उसको हम डेल्टा कहते हैं. वी कॉल इट डेल्टा. So you can read it that Delta variant of SARS-CoV-2 is B.1.617.2. According to INSAGOG, INSAGOG is a consortium of laboratories which studies the mutations in coronavirus. So the prevalence rate of the Delta variant in India currently was 67%, and it was first identified in India in October 2022. एंड इट हैज़ फर्दर म्यूटेटेड एंड नाउ हैज़ अ टोटल ऑफ 13 सब लीनेजेस. मीन्स अब जो बी डॉट वन डॉट सिक्स वन सेवन डॉट टू डॉट वन को हम ए वाई डॉट वन कहते हैं, बी वन सिक्स वन सेवन डॉट वन टू को वी कॉल इट ए वाई डॉट ट्वेल्व. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द प्रेसिडेंट्स कलर द हाइस्ट ऑनर बेस्टोड ऑन अ मिलिट्री यूनिट इन रिकग्निशन ऑफ हिज एक्सेप्शनल सर्विस टू द नेशन वॉज टू बी बेस्टोड अपॉन आर्मी एविएशन कॉर्प्स, इंडियन नेवल एविएशन, इंडियन कोस्ट गार्ड, इंडियन एयरफोर्स और नन ऑफ द अबव. सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज बी, इंडियन नेवल एविएशन. सो इन 2021 इंडियन नेवल एविएशन वॉज अवॉर्डेड द प्रेसिडेंट्स कलर अवार्ड. This award was awarded at INS Hansa in Goa. What is the importance of President's Colour Award? It is the highest honor bestowed on military unit. So it is the highest honor bestowed on military unit in recognition of its exceptional service to the nation. Now let's have the history little. That Navy was the first armed forces in India to be awarded the President's Colour in 1951. Now, naval aviation, it came into existence in 1951 by the commissioning of INS Garuda. Right now, naval aviation, it boasts of 9 air stations and 3 naval air enclaves along the coastline, and one is in Andaman and Nicobar Island. Now, national aviation, they have played a very major role in certain operations such as Operation Cactus, Jupiter, Shield, Vijay and Parakram. And in humanitarian and disaster relief both. Now the next question is, the Dipor Bil Wildlife Sanctuary is in which of the following states? West Bengal, Odisha, Tripura, Assam, none of the above. So the correct answer is D, Assam. Dipor Bil Wildlife Sanctuary is in Assam. It is the only Ramsar site in Assam. Now why it was in news? Because due to increasing case of pollution in Dipor Bil, it is a wildlife sanctuary as well as Ramsar site. Ramsar site means wetland of international importance. So the Union Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change notified Dipor Bil as the eco-sensitive zone. When any area is declared as eco-sensitive zone, so there are preventions and prohibitions imposed on construction activities or any other anthropogenic activities which can harm the environment. Now in India there are total number of 46 Ramsar sites. Now in 2021 August 2021 four Ramsar sites were in news because they are the recently declared Ramsar site in India. Two are in Haryana and two are in Gujarat. So Bhindawas Wildlife Sanctuary and Sultanpur National Park, they have been designated as Ramsar site. They are in Haryana. Then Thol Lake Wildlife Sanctuary and Vadhvana Wildlife Sanctuary, they are also Ramsar site and they are in Gujarat. The next question is, the Zapad exercise 2021 was held in which of the following? This is very important exercise, especially from the exam point of view. I hope that you people give me the right answer. It was in news prominently. So Zapad exercise 2021 was held in A, Russia, B, Tajikistan, C, Mongolia, D, UAE, E, all of the above. So the correct answer is A, Russia. So exercise Zapad 2021, it was held in Nizhny, Russia. There were total 17 countries invited for the exercise, out of which 8 countries were observer countries and other 9 were participating countries. The 9 participating countries were Mongolia, Armenia, Kazakhstan, Tajikistan, Kyrgyzstan, Serbia, Russia, India and Belarus. Now the observer countries were Pakistan, China, Vietnam, Malaysia, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Uzbekistan and Sri Lanka. Now Zapad 21 exercise, you have to understand that this exercise, it focuses on enhancing the military and strategic ties among the participating nation and to undertake such operations to fight terrorism. And from India, the Naga Battalion Group of Indian Army participated in Zapad exercise 2021. Now the question comes that what is the exercise which was carried by SCO country? So if you know the military exercise which was carried out by SCO, Shanghai Cooperation Organization, countries recently, please write me in the comment box. On September 2, 2021, the Union Health Ministry made RT-PCR mandatory for travelers coming from certain countries. Now you have to tell me that which of the country was not included in it. The list was released on September 2, 2021. So A. South Africa, B. Bangladesh, C. China, D. New Zealand, E. None of the above. So the correct answer is E. None of the above. So the Union Health Ministry mandated passengers from South Africa, Bangladesh, Botswana, China, Mauritius, New Zealand and Zimbabwe to undergo RT-PCR test on their arrival in India. Now already passengers who are coming from the United Kingdom, rest of the Europe and Middle East, they have to take this test. Now these international passengers, they have to undergo pre-arrival RT-PCR testing at least 70 hours before boarding. Okay, and only those passengers will be allowed who have asymptomatic. Only asymptomatic passengers are allowed to board a flight, means they should not show any symptoms. Now the next question is that the Speaker of the Lok Sabha addresses his resignation to A. President of India, B. Prime Minister of India, C. Vice President of India, D. Deputy Speaker, E. None of the above. The correct answer is Deputy Speaker. So under Article 94 of the Constitution, this is very important. The Speaker of Lok Sabha addresses his resignation to the Deputy Speaker, and the Deputy Speaker addresses his resignation to the Speaker of Lok Sabha. In India, Speakers and Deputy Speakers are elected by the members of the Lok Sabha, and it is a convention, not written in Constitution, but it is a convention that Speaker will come from ruling party or coalition and Deputy Speaker comes from opposition party or coalition. Now why the office of Speaker is, the Deputy Speaker was in news, that till now the Deputy Speaker for the current Lok Sabha has not been elected. The next question is about the Defence Expo 2022. It was in news, so it is very important from exam point of view also. So the Defence Expo 2022 is to be held at which of the following city? It's to be held at which of the following city? A. Ahmedabad, B. Gandhinagar, C. Pune, D. Chennai, E. None of the above. So the correct answer is Gandhinagar. So the 12th edition of the Biennial Defense Expo, which is India's flagship event showcasing the land, naval, air as well as homeland security systems, will be held in Gandhinagar, Gujarat between March 10 and 13, 2022. The next question is that which of the following person was awarded the Behler Turtle Conservation Award in September 2021? A. Shailendra Singh, B. Tejendra Singh, C. Deepak Rawat, D. Rajesh Srivastav, E. None of the above. So the correct answer is Shailendra Singh. Now see, Indian biologist Shailendra Singh, he has been awarded the Behler Turtle Conservation Award. Why? For bringing three critically endangered turtle species back from brink of extinction. And these three species are a red-crowned roof turtle, northern river terrapin, and black soft-shell turtle. Now, this Behler Turtle Conservation Award, it is awarded by various consortium of international organizations, which are Turtle Survival Alliance, IUCN, that is International Union for Conservation of Nature, SSC Tortoise and Fresh Water Turtle Specialist Group, Turtle Conservancy and the Turtle Conservation Fund. Now the World Turtle Day, this is also important. World Turtle Day is annually observed on 23rd May. In India, there is a Kurma app. It was launched for turtle conservation. It's a turtle app, turtle conservation app. Now, the Turtle Surveillance Survival Alliance, it was formed in 2001 as an international union for conservation of union partnership. Okay, means with the partnership of International Union for Conservation of Nature, सस्टेनेबल कैप्टिव मैनेजमेंट ऑफ फ्रेश वाटर टर्टल्स एंड टॉर्टाइज। कैप्टिव मैनेजमेंट मीन्स कि उसको कहीं पे कंजर्व करके रखना और फिर उसको पालना। नाउ व्हाट इज द मिशन ऑफ टर्टल सर्वाइवल अलायंस? सो द मिशन ऑफ टर्टल सर्वाइवल अलायंस इज जीरो टर्टल एक्सटिंक्शन इन द 21st सेंचुरी। नाउ एन एयर लॉन्च अनमैंड एरियल व्हीकल अंडर द डिफेंस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड ट्रेड इनिशिएटिव इट वॉज साइन बिटवीन इंडिया एंड विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंट्री? ए फ्रांस, बी यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स, सी यूनाइटेड किंगडम, डी रशिया, ई नन ऑफ द अबव। सो लेट्स सी द करेक्ट आंसर। सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स। सो इंडिया एंड यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स दे साइंड अ प्रोजेक्ट एग्रीमेंट ऑन July 30, 2021 for an air launched unmanned aerial vehicle under defense technology and trade initiative. Even if the question comes that defense technology and trade initiative is a partnership between which two countries, so it is India and US. The next is that which of the following SARS-CoV-2 vaccine has not received approval of trial or emergency use authorization for children? So certain vaccines, they have been given authorization for trial or emergency use authorization for children. You have to identify that which vaccine has not got either of the two. Usko na trial mila hai, trial ka approval mila hai na emergency use authorization ka mila hai permission. So A is Zycov-D, B is Covaxin, C is Corbevax, D is Covishield, E all of the above. We are talking about India. So the correct answer is Covishield. Now let's see the rationale, which is important. Zycov-D, which is being manufactured by Zydus Cadila, it has received authorization for emergency use in children who are over 12 years in age. Then Covaxin trials among children are being carried out. The Drug Control of India approved Corbovax, approved by Biological E, for carrying out trials for children to 12 years of age. Then Bhitarkarnika National Park. Bhitarkarnika National Park is in which of the following state? Bhitarkarnika National Park is in which of the following state? A. West Bengal, B. Odisha, C. Andhra Pradesh, D. Tamil Nadu, E. none of the above. So the correct answer is Odisha. So Bhitarkarnika National Park is in Kendrapara, Odisha. It was designated as Ramsar site in 2002. It is a mangrove forest, and the additional information is that it is famous for salt water crocodile. Now, the Shanghai Cooperation Organization Heads of Government meeting in September 2021 was held in A. Saint Petersburg, Russia, B. Dushanbe, Tajikistan, C. Beijing, China, D. Tashkent in Uzbekistan, and then E. none of the above. So the correct answer is Dushanbe, Tajikistan. Now the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, okay, or Shanghai Pact, it is an Eurasian political, economic and security alliance. It is the world's largest regional organization in terms of geographical area and population. It covers 3/5 of the Eurasian continent, 40% of the world population, and more than 20% of global GDP. It is headquartered at Beijing, China, and the official language is Russian and Chinese. And the recent meeting was held in Dushanbe, Tajikistan. The next question is that the BRICS Leaders Summit 2021, which was headed by India, which of the following were the priority areas of this BRICS Leaders Summit 2021? A is multilateral reforms in United Nations body, IMF and World Trade Organization. B is counter-terrorism. C is technology. D is people-to-people exchange. E is all of the above. So the correct answer is E, all of the above. So 13th BRICS Leaders Summit, which was headed by the Prime Minister of India, had four broad priority areas. The first one was multilateral reforms in United Nations bodies, IMF and WTO. The second is counter-terrorism. The third is technology. The fourth is people to people exchange. Now the next question, the National Bureau of Animal Genetic Resources recognized Dash as the 19th unique breed of buffaloes in India. A. Surti, B. Jafarabadi, C. Murra, D. Manda, E. None of the above. So the correct answer is D. Manda. So Manda buffaloes, which are found in Eastern Ghats and Koraput region of Odisha, they were identified as the 19th unique breed of buffaloes found in India. They are resistant to parasitic infections. They are less prone to disease and they can thrive on modest resources. Now the next question, ChAdOx1, a vaccine vector which was in news recently, is a vaccine for, so let me give you an information, it is a potential vaccine for corona already, because if you mix the spike protein with ChAdOx1, if you develop ChAdOx1 with spike protein, you get the corona vaccine, but this ChAdOx1, which is a vaccine vector, if it is modified with some other virus, so it can be vaccine for that virus also. You have to identify for which disease it can be used. So the first is tuberculosis, B is MERS, C is Nipah, D is Dengue, E is none of the above. So the correct answer is Nipah. So the preliminary animal trial results seem to suggest that ChAdOx vaccine vector, when it is customized with a glycoprotein of Nipah virus, it has fully protected African green monkeys. Now ChAdOx1, it is a multi-purpose vaccine vector. It can be customized to carry DNA from a wide variety of pathogens. Means if it is modified with other viruses, some parts of other viruses through DNA technology, so it can be developed as vaccine. Now this ChAdOx1 has been used in the manufacture of Covishield or AstraZeneca. So this ChAdOx was modified with the spike protein of corona, SARS-CoV-2. The next is that which of the following countries set up the ministry to address the impact of climate change? A. Belarus, B. Serbia, C. Greece, D. Turkey, E. None of the above. So the correct answer is A. Greece. So Greece has created a ministry to address the impact of climate change, and and Christos Stylianides is the minister. He has served as the commissioner for humanitarian aid and crisis management between 2014 and 2019. Now why Greece has formed the ministry? Because if you see the July and August 2021, the intense heat wave condition was there in southern Europe, which then deadly wildfires in Turkey and Italy, France and Balkan countries. Now you have to identify the factually correct statement. The question is coming from the recent news. So Mullah Muhammad Hassan Akhund has been named as the interim prime minister of Afghanistan by Taliban. Sirajuddin Haqqani was appointed as the interior minister. Ahmed Massoud was appointed as the foreign minister. Abdul Ghani Baradar was appointed as the Deputy Prime Minister of Afghanistan by Taliban. E. None of the above. The correct answer is C. Ahmed Massoud. So Ahmed Massoud is a part of the National Resistance Front who are opposing the rule of Taliban. He is the son of Ahmed Shah Massoud. The National Resistance Front is based in Panjshir Valley, north of Kabul. The next. Based on the school children's online and offline learning survey, the proportion of school children in rural area attending the online classes regularly were how much? A. 24%, B. 8%, C. 30%, D. 10%, E. None of the above. So the correct answer is 8%. So according to the school children's online and offline learning school survey, the proportion of school children who were studying online regularly was just 24% in urban area and 8% in rural area. Then among Dalit and Adivasi, only 5% of the children had access to online classes. Then the International Day of Literacy, it is annually observed on 8th September 2021. The theme for 2021 was literacy for a human centered recovery narrowing the digital divide. So you can see the theme is matching with the survey results. Now the Union Cabinet in September released an outlay of dash crore for PLI scheme to attract fresh investment in the man-made fiber, apparel, fabrics and technical textile sector. So A, rupees 20,000 crore, B, rupees 10,000 crore, C, rupees 10,680 crore, D, rupees 11,780 crore, E, none of the above. The correct answer is 10,683 crore. So the Union Cabinet has cleared an outlay of rupees 10,680 crore on production linked incentive scheme, which aims at bringing fresh investment for MMF, which is man-made fiber apparel, technical textiles, and it aims to draw new investment in this sector of rupees 19,000 crore and generation of 7.5 lakh direct jobs. The next is, which of the following state recently, as on September 2021, passed 75% reservation in jobs for locals? A, Jharkhand, B, Chhattisgarh, C, Odisha, D, West Bengal, E, none of the above. So the correct answer is Jharkhand. So the Jharkhand Legislative Assembly passed the Jharkhand State Employment of Local Candidates Bill 2021, which provides 75% reservation for locals in private sector's job with a monthly salary of 40,000. Okay, means up to the monthly salary of 40,000. Okay, and now once notified, then after Andhra Pradesh and Haryana, Jharkhand will be the third state to pass such a law. Now you have to identify the incorrect statement related to Sputnik 5. It is manufactured by Gamaleya Research Institute in Moscow, Russia. Sputnik Light is a single dose vaccine. Dr. Reddy's laboratory has license to supply Sputnik in India, and it is the first DNA vaccine which is used in India. E, none of the above. So the correct answer is D. So C, which is the first DNA vaccine in India, Zycov D, manufactured by Zydus Cadila, is the first DNA vaccine for COVID-19. It is a three dose vaccine which is manufactured in India. The next, R. N. Ravi was appointed as the governor of A, Tamil Nadu, B, Telangana, C, Nagaland, D, Mizoram, E, none of the above. So the correct answer is Tamil Nadu. So if you can see, Sri R. N. Ravi, he was appointed as the governor of Tamil Nadu. Lieutenant General Gurmeet Singh, okay, he has been made the governor of Uttarakhand. And Assam Governor Jagdish Mukhi, he has been given the additional charge of Nagaland. R. N. Ravi was earlier the governor of Nagaland. Now see the constitutional articles related to governor. Article 155 says that the governor of state shall be appointed by the president by warrant under his hand and seal. Then Article 156 says that the governor shall hold the office during the pleasure of president. The governor addresses his resignation to the president. Now see, confirming to this provision that governor shall hold the office during the pleasure of the president, normally a governor shall hold office for a term of 5 years subject to the above condition. Now Article 157 says that no person shall be eligible for appointment as governor unless that person is citizen of India and has completed the age of 35 years. The next, who among the following became the first qualifier in the Open era to win a Grand Slam? A, Serena Williams, B, Maria Sharapova, C, Emma Raducanu, D, Steffi Graf, E, none of the above. So the correct answer is Emma Raducanu. So the 18-year-old British tennis player Emma Raducanu, she has won the US Open women's title in 2021, and she is the first qualifier in the Open era to win a Grand Slam. Now the indigenously developed saline gargle RT-PCR test was developed by which of the following? A, ICMR, B, NIRI, C, Biological E, D, Serum Institute of India, E, none of the above. The correct answer is NIRI. So the Nagpur based National Environmental Engineering Research Institute has developed the saline gargle RT-PCR technique and later it transferred it to Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises for commercializing it. It is simple, fast, cost effective, patient friendly and comfortable, and it provides instant test result, and it is specially well suited for rural and tribal areas. NIRI, it is an institute under the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. Now, the next question, the systematic enzyme and probiotic supplement dash and dash has recently passed the randomized controlled clinical trials in terms of efficacy to resolve post-COVID-19 fatigue symptoms. A. Immunosab and rifampicin. B. Probio SCB CSC3 and rifampicin. C. Rifampicin and remdesivir. D. Immunosab and Probiosab CSC3. E. None of the above. So the correct answer is D. Immunosab and Probiosab CSC3. The next is, the Dronier aircraft was given on lease by the Indian Navy to which of the following country? A. Myanmar. D. Maldives. C. Mauritius. D. Malaysia. E. None of the above. So the correct answer is Mauritius. So the Indian Navy leased Dornier aircraft on lease to the Maritime Air Squadron of the National Coast Guard, Mauritius. Hope you must have found the video very informative. Thank you everyone. Take care.